Welcome back. We have returned to the Isle of Wonder, carrying the dangling participle, which is one of the things the bookworm said he would trade for a rare book, which we can then trade to the bookstore owner for that book of magic spells. And let's talk to the bookworm.
Are you there, most venerable bookworm?
Do you have anything interesting yet? Falling arches, perhaps?
Let me see what I have.
Actually, I think you can give him, try to give him Rotten Tomato. Let's see.
I have a Rotten Tomato.
I'm sure you do, son. But there's nothing I can do about it.
Ah. I was hoping for a comment from Rotten Tomato himself, but too bad.
Are you there, most venerable bookworm?
Do you have anything interesting yet? A prepositional phrase, possibly?
Let me see what I have.
We have a dangling participle, like you asked us for.
I found this little fellow lost on another island.
Coming home, I am too.
There you are, you naughty boy. I told you not to leave the island.
Glad I am seeing you too.
A most solemn celebration.
So, you found my dangling participle. I suppose I'll have to give you something. Let's see now. Was it a rare book you wanted?
Yes, sir.
Well, then none of these will do. They've been sitting in the sun far too long and must be well cooked by now. This one is far more rare. A delicious little tidbit.
Thanks.
Okay. He was certainly weird. But we got, a rare book. With the letter R on it. R on it for rare, I guess.
Alexander is carrying a rare book from the bookworm. The words in the binding are very faint. The something-something riddle book.
Or for riddles. Let's read it before we give it away.
Alexander opens the rare book and looks inside. The book contains riddles and has a page missing. Alexander glances at a few of the conundrums, but finds himself more curious about the one that is missing. What was the riddle, he wonders? More importantly, what was the answer?
Now here, it's important to notice that the pattern on the missing page matches the piece of paper we found in the spiderweb. So whatever the riddle was, the answer apparently was love. And that is, after all you need, so why wouldn't it be the answer? Okay, I want to head back to the garden while we're here. Last time I was here, I commented about the wallflowers being more commonly found at a dance, but that there was no music for them to dance to. This time, we brought our own music.
May I have this dance?
Oh, my!
Alexander stops playing the flute, but the wallflowers and snapdragons continue to dance, caught up in the music and oblivious to everything around them.
And that gives us the opportunity to snatch the wallflower. Hole in the wall.
While the wallflowers dance, Alexander snatches the hole in the wall.
Useful if we ever have a wall that needs a hole.
The hole in the wall has four legs and a curly tail. He's all limbs with only a hole for a body. But that doesn't make him any less whole.
Dear God. Of all the puns, that has to be the worst one. And let's get a new lettuce.
Alexander picks a head of iceberg lettuce.
Ye gads! Is that cold?
Which we can use for the boiling pond, perhaps, maybe. But we need to hurry, otherwise it'll melt again. So, although we have a book to trade with the bookshop owner, let's first head back to...
Alexander pulls out his magic map.
To the Isle of the Beast, to see if we can do anything with that pond.
Alexander feels a strange pulling sensation.
Okay. Let's throw in a frozen head of lettuce and see what happens.
Hoping to cool down the boiling pond, Alexander throws in a head of iceberg lettuce. The pond's water slowly stops boiling, cooled by the ice. It still looks hot, but bearable.
Well, that looks a lot better. Maybe we'll be able to cross it now.
Alexander decides to brave the steaming pond.
Ouch! Ow! Ooh, 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 ouch!
The pond is no longer boiling, but it's hardly bathwater.
Also seems to be a lot less deep than last time. I guess it's magic or something. And now we can get that hunter's lamp.
Alexander takes the old hunter's lamp from the tree.
Let's see if there's a genie in it. Maybe a genie that will give us a bridle that we can use to defeat a snake.
Alexander rubs the lamp, but nothing happens.
Well, according to the story in the guidebook, you actually have to open the lamp to let the genie out. But I guess either Alexander doesn't know that. Or there really is no genie in this lamp. I guess we could always try and trade it for another lamp with the lamp peddler in town. You don't need to worry about this pond, by the way. It will not get to boiling again. So we can cross it now whenever we want.
As Alexander continues down the path, he gets the strange feeling that he's being watched.
Come on over here and see what I'm doing with these flowers. Never mind that stone fella on top of the gate. He won't hurt you any. He's just there to scare you.
Hmm. Another fellow with glowing yellow eyes. I'm very suspicious of that.
A pleasant-looking middle-aged man is busy tending a small garden just past the wall.
Yeah, pleasant-looking. Are you sure he's not another incarnation of that genie?
I'm Alexander of Daventry. Who are you?
What difference does it make? Just come on over here. I'll tell you my life history if you still want to hear it.
Well, I don't see what harm it could do to go over there. Yikes! What the hell's that?
A stone archer sits atop the lintel of the gate like a silent guardian. His stone bow is tightly drawn and fitted with a single stone arrow.
Well, the gardener guy said he wasn't dangerous, and I guess we can trust him. Yeah, as if.
Gotcha this time! Tickets! Oh! Next!
That move was slightly erroneous.
Oh, I see what you did there. Well, that didn't end quite the way we were hoping. It is, however, a good thing in a way, because I guess it means that the genie can't just outright kill us. He has to somehow...
Come on through, I say. I can show you a path through the forest.
He has to somehow trick us, apparently. Which makes us a lot safer than if he could just come out and kill us outright.
A brick lies in the grass. It must have come from the old brick wall.
A loose brick. Let's see, that might be useful. Maybe we can break him.
There's no reason. Alexander picks up the brick.
Can we break him? I guess not, but who knows?
Perhaps you'd find this interesting.
Sure, bring it on over to this side of the wall where I can see it better.
Nice try. But you're not fooling me again.
Look, there's no point in hanging out here all day. I can show you the wondrous castle that lies in the middle of the island. Don't be so timid.
He's not entirely lying. He has no intention of showing it to us, but there is a castle. But I don't trust him. Let's see what happens if we just wait, because previous times it didn't seem like the genie had a lot of patience. If indeed this is the genie.
You aren't going to listen to me, are you? Well, we'll just see about that.
That's odd. The gardener just disappeared.
Well, that clinches it. He's definitely the genie. That, or he's got a teleportation at random spell. Can we use the brick against this thing?
Throwing the brick at the stone archer might scratch his marble, but it won't stop the archer's vigilant watch over the path.
Nope. Well, I don't think we have anything that can get us past the archer. Maybe Rotten Tomato.
The stone archer would undoubtedly shoot Alexander long before he managed to climb up the wall to try that.
That wanted to throw Rotten Tomato at it. After all, that's what you do with Rotten Tomatoes, isn't it? Throw them. Oh well, I guess we can't go any further for now. So we'll see what else we can do in the next video.